The folks at this quarry in Claughton, near Lancashire, dig up about 60,000 tonnes of shale rock from the ground every year. That shale needs to get to the brickworks about a mile and a half that way. Nowadays, you'd have some fancy underground conveyor belt, or you'd just have trucks loading up and driving back and forth. But this quarry opened in the 1920s, so the solution was a bit different, an aerial ropeway. This is the last aerial ropeway in Britain. It's nearly 100 years old. It needs no fuel and no electricity to run. And in 15 years' time, it'll be gone. Yep.
This ropeway was commissioned in the 1920s, but we've been quarrying from this valley now for well over 150 years. An empty bucket arrives, it goes onto what we call the bull rail, so that automatically comes off the rope and it allows the rope to go round a wheel. The bucket then is dusted if the weather is bad. The rain adheres to the bucket and the muck sticks to it. So that would reduce what is taken down to the factory and also would affect the balance of the rope. And then it puts under a feeder where a given amount of material is put into that bucket, about a quarter of a tonne. At that point, another operative takes the full bucket from under the feeder and waits till the correct positioning of the incoming bucket is in place, allows him then to feed it onto the rope. That spacing is critical because of the way the rope works. It's gravity fed.
The brickworks is downhill from here, so all the power for this ropeway comes from gravity. Put the full buckets of shale on one side going down the hill and the empty buckets on the other side going up, and you don't need an engine house or a motor, you just need brakes to regulate the speed. It takes about half an hour for a round trip. There are about 40 buckets. This ropeway will move about 300 tons of shale every day with no need for petrol or electricity. So let's go to the brickworks at the other end and see how it works down there.
As the bucket comes in the other end, an operator is stood waiting for it. It comes off the rope at a given speed onto a bull rail. From that bull rail, the operator walks round. There's a pivot system on the bucket that tips into a hopper. At that point, it then feeds into a dump truck. The operator then puts the bucket back. When the correct spacing is positioned, he pushes the bucket onto the rope. It's an art to swing that bucket and tip it at the right time. They do walk quite a few miles in a day. This factory was designed to produce around about 42 million bricks annually. There was a 4.4 million investment 4 years ago that increased the productivity up to 50 million. Claughton produces frost-resistant product. It's down to the shale from the quarry. That's a vital key to it. The temperature we fire at and also the durability of the ceramic bond. That means we can sell this product into all extreme weathers. There's nowhere in the UK we can't sell to with our durability of the product at Claughton. Unfortunately, it has to cross the road. It's never been known, certainly in the last 50, 60 years, to come off at that point, but it is a possibility. So we have a steel bridge with big bucket catchers on the side that would prevent that happening. The rope construction is a 25 millimetre steel rope. Very difficult to get contractors these days who are skilled in splicing ropes of that size. We replace the rope every 6 years. It's a very, very difficult process, it's very old. The technology is the 1920s, of course. We did a computer design of a new ropeway many years ago, and unbelievably, the computer matched this design in terms of trestle heights and weights to somebody with a slide rule and a pencil.
There used to be hundreds of these ropeways around Britain in industrial sites, mines and quarries. This is the last one still operating anywhere in the country. It nearly wasn't. The financial crisis in the late 2000s meant that the quarry and brickworks shut down for a few years. But it was kept in working order, and as of right now, it's still transporting rock. But it has an expiry date, 31st of December 2036. Permission for quarrying was going to end in 2018, but the local council planning department granted an extension because the quarry and brickworks are still operating. There's a lot of shale still in the hill up there, and literally no one objected. I checked the planning report, environmental agencies, local residents, everyone was like, yeah, fine, keep it running, that works. Now, in theory, that deadline could be extended again, but the reason they picked 2036 is that by then, the company will more or less have quarried everything they can out of that hill. And one of the conditions of that time extension is that once quarrying is finished, the ropeway has to come down. The planning report does acknowledge that it's unique in the country. It's the only one left in Britain. There is some heritage value in it. But they say not enough to justify saving it for posterity. This isn't like an old railway line where if it's left unmaintained, it'll just slowly, steadily decay. It could be actively dangerous if the ropes and towers start to fall apart, particularly when they run over a road just there. Unless money is constantly spent to keep it in working order, it'll decay into an unsafe blot on the landscape. Which is fair, but I suspect when that final day comes in about 15 years' time, when the last bucket goes down the ropeway, there'll be a few people here to say goodbye to it. And until then, it'll keep moving shale without needing any fuel at all. Thank you so much to all the team at Forterra for showing me around. They did ask me to make clear that the ropeway is not a tourist attraction, so if you're in the area and you want to take a couple of pictures from the road, sure, but then for their sake, please keep driving.